It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
Hey guys, Tyler here. Black Lives Matter is pretty much the stop police. It's kind of funny because Black Lives Matter supposedly is against like police brutality against black people. But here we have Black Lives Matter being the stop police for everybody else who do not actually agree with their movement. Now, there are just so many stories on various articles for newspapers and magazines talking about how various people are fired from their jobs just because they posted something like All Lives Matter or something on their post on Twitter. And of course, they lost their whole entire livelihood because of that whole entire scenario. And it's just kind of sad, very, very sad, that we live in a time where if we post something like All Lives Matter, you're more than likely gonna lose your job because you post something like All Lives Matter. And it's sad because All Lives Matter includes black lives. And so they're saying that black lives matter too, but whatever. I guess they, you know, want to have less people who are tolerant in their whole entire building because, hey, you know, All Lives Matter is like the most racist piece of garbage we could possibly think of. As everybody knows, there has been various reports of these cities putting the words Black Lives Matter on the ground. And matter of fact, in Washington, D.C., they have an entire street that is called Black Lives Matter. But getting back to that story that I just talked about a minute ago, I just find it so funny and so ironic that these businesses are firing people for saying All Lives Matter, because it reminds me so much about a conflict on YouTube in the past. Now, the past conflict on YouTube on Twitter was that various feminists were getting out their way to cancel people at their job for criticizing feminism or saying something negative about feminism. And of course, a lot of people lost their job during the whole entire, you know, Gamergate debacle. And it's so sad to see that we're repeating history yet again. But hey, I'm not surprised, because people who do not know their history, they tend to repeat it. So naturally, of course, we're seeing this whole entire cycle happen again and again and again and again. More recently, a couple went out their way to paint the Black Lives Matter sign on the ground black. And of course, according to a report by the police station in California, they're being charged with a hate crime. I am not kidding. According to official reports, they're actually being charged for a hate crime. We live in a country where it's perfectly okay to knock down statues of controversial figures. We live in a country where pretty much people can protest en masse with their masks on without any sort of consequences because reasons. But for some strange reason, if you were to express your opinion on the ground about how you feel about Black Lives Matter, that's a hate crime. Now, the last time I checked, according to the definition of hate crime is an attack on a person or a group of people based upon race, based upon sexual orientation, blah, 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 blah. And the last time I checked, Black Lives Matter is not a race of people. Black Lives Matter is a movement. Black Lives Matter is a set of ideologies. So to me, when you criticize Black Lives Matter, you're criticizing a set of ideas. You're not criticizing black people just because they hold these kind of views. It is just sad, just so, so sad, that my country is bending free speech for Black Lives Matter. If you criticize Black Lives Matter, you get fired. If you express that you don't like Black Lives Matter, you're doing a hate crime. Blah, 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 blah. And it's just so ridiculous, so utterly ridiculous, that we're sacrificing our free speech because of these giant corporations that actually support these sort of movements like Black Lives Matter. Really. It is just so sad, it is so ridiculous, that I had to even discuss this year. But what do you guys think? Tell me in the comment section down below, and I'll see you guys next time.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.
He's your only black friend, so he's your best black friend. I wouldn't trade him for another black friend. Because black friends are rare, as you should be aware. He smiles like Richard Pryor, so just sit and stare.
It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler. It's everyone's friend, it's Tyler.